Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. This video is a bit different from the channel's typical content. I recently had a chance to poke around the new ChatGPT chatbot and ask it some representative questions about organic chemistry. I thought the answers were interesting, so I'm sharing the chat in this video. First, what is ChatGPT? It is an AI-driven chatbot. GPT stands for Generative Pre-trained Transformer. The chatbot can be accessed at chat.openai.com. It was first launched at the end of November of 2022. The developer is OpenAI. When ChatGPT was first released, it created a big splash in the media. I work at a small college, and initially there was a lot of concern about whether ChatGPT posed a cheating risk. So, would students use ChatGPT to write their essays or to get help on tests? I follow a lot of content creators on YouTube, and some of these creators there gave an initial review of ChatGPT. And the first impressions were that ChatGPT can be quite error-prone when it comes to details. So with this in mind, I decided to explore ChatGPT. I decided to ask questions that would show up typically in first semester organic chemistry. So I asked 14 questions in total, and those questions and ChatGPT's responses make up the rest of this video. Question 1. What is the elimination product of chlorocyclohexane? Here is ChatGPT's answer. Right off the bat, it misidentifies the product as 1,3-cyclohexadiene. This reaction has nothing to do with the Diels alder. But otherwise, the answer is okay. It is a dehydrochlorination. This is not a terrible start, even though it did mess up the product. Question 2. What is the product during reaction of chlorocyclohexane and sodium hydroxide? This is another miss, and I find this answer a bit more troubling. The reaction is a clear E2, and ChatGPT went with a substitution. The answer does not explicitly say SN2, but I suspect that's what ChatGPT was indicating. Is that fair to interpret a chatbot's answer for intent? I don't know. I didn't do it during my session, but a good follow-up question would be to ask whether the reaction would go through an SN2 or SN1 pathway. Regardless, the rest of the text is at least consistent with the predicted product. It's the wrong answer, but it is internally consistent. Question 3. What is product during reaction of cyclohexane and NaOH? I screwed up this question. I meant to ask about cyclohexene, but I typed cyclohexane. I wanted to give ChatGPT a nonsense reaction, but the reaction ended up being more ridiculous than intended. My English also leaves something to be desired. I initially laughed at ChatGPT's response. It's complete garbage. In hindsight, I'm a bit more forgiving. My question was junk, and ChatGPT gave me junk right back. Garbage in, garbage out. I do think this answer might indicate that I don't know or the dreaded no reaction are not part of ChatGPT's training, or not enough of a part that it will respond with no reaction. ChatGPT will likely create an answer even if there isn't one. Question 4. Is sodium hydroxide a good base for an E2 reaction? After getting a bit too fancy in the previous question, I wanted to ask a relatively direct question. ChatGPT gives the wrong answer, no, and then contradicts itself in the second line. Hydroxide is a strong base. It then justifies its wrong answer and gets some details wrong along the way. For example, carbocations in the E2 and abstracting the alpha proton instead of the beta. This was a bad miss. Question 5. Is sodium hydroxide a good nucleophile for an SN2 reaction? This answer was actually pretty decent. It got a bit sideways about the spreading of the charge, but there is okay information in here, and eventually the answer got around to the basicity of hydroxide. I don't know if this is a real thing, but I did notice at this point that ChatGPT seemed to be serving me longer and longer responses. This trend will continue, and the answers to the next questions will continue to get longer, but not better. Question 6. Is azide anion a good nucleophile for an SN2 reaction? This answer was essentially spot on. It even properly addressed the degree of substitution of the leaving group. Of course, I would expect this to be an easier question. My only complaint would be the mention of a triple bond in azide. You can draw a resonance form of azide with a triple bond, but it would not be my first thought. Regardless, this isn't a time to bicker over relative stability of resonance forms unless I asked about resonance forms in the question. The mention of a triple bond did make me think that ChatGPT was picking up text about cyanide instead of azide. That leads to the next question. Question 7. Is cyanide a good nucleophile for an SN2 reaction? This wasn't as good of an answer. The triple bond is back, and now makes sense. But the negative charge, the highly negative charge, on nitrogen is out of place. The SN2 on tertiary halides is also a problem. The rest of the text is okay, and even throws in a safety warning. Not as good as the azide answer, but borderline okay. Again, notice the length. ChatGPT is definitely bending your ear, even with a fairly simple question. Question 8. How can you make one pentene from one pentanol? I was curious to see if ChatGPT would favor an E1 or the more controlled E2 pathway. Instead, ChatGPT just made some things up. Dehydrogenation, and oxidations. It seemed to ignore the alcohol and want to start with pentane. I guess it's hard to tell what it was doing. The last option was to use sulfuric acid. I thought it was taking the E1 road, but it threw in an oxidant. My best guess is that ChatGPT didn't understand what I was asking and just threw back the best from among several poor matches. So it would be nice if ChatGPT would ask me to rephrase my question. Question 9. How can you make pentane nitrile from 1-chlorobutane? I went to a more direct question, and ChatGPT pretty much nailed it with a bonus of additional considerations, generic considerations, about reaction conditions and even safety concerns. This is a good answer to a well-defined question. The next question gets trickier. Question 10. How does cyanide react with 2-bromo-2-methyl-propane? Here is a dreaded no reaction question. Every student hates this question. Apparently, ChatGPT does too. ChatGPT runs with the nucleophilicity of cyanide and does an SN2 on the tertiary halide. While wrong, I'll give ChatGPT a pass here. This question almost qualifies as entrapment. Notice again how long the responses are getting. ChatGPT is living up to its name. Question 11. Is an SN2 or E2 reaction more common? I thought I'd give a more vague question with no real answer. After trying to show off everything it knows and making several mistakes along the way, the end of the answer was actually excellent. It depends. The last three sentences would have been an excellent reply. Note that the response is so long that I can't do a screen grab and fit the answer in a legible size. Even the text I show on this screen is a much smaller font than I like to use in these videos. Question 12. Why is tosylate such a good leaving group? This answer wasn't perfect. For example, getting the negative charge on the sulfur poses a challenge. Still, on the whole, ChatGPT did a good job on this and even managed to keep on topic through the entire answer. Let's turn things around a bit. Question 13. Why is tosylate such a poor leaving group? This is another semi-entrapment question. ChatGPT immediately reversed course from the previous answer and apologized for saying that tosylate is a good leaving group. I didn't know that ChatGPT connected responses in this way. ChatGPT seems to be confusing the stability of tosylate as an anion with a lack of reactivity in the parent tosylate ester. Anyway, I was surprised that ChatGPT so easily did a 180 from its previous answer, a previously correct answer. Question 14. Why does acetic acid have a lower pKa than ethanol? I was tired of asking questions at this point. This is the last one. ChatGPT opens the response well, but it's justification with H plus ions, the electron withdrawing properties of the carbonyl and bond energies are all over the place. This answer is long. There may be bits of truth hidden in here, but ChatGPT seems to be grasping at straws in this response. What are my final thoughts on ChatGPT? I was initially worried that I needed to change how I write my tests and homework sets. I no longer think I need to worry. I don't think ChatGPT is reliable enough for a student to cheat with it. Even if some of the answers are generally correct, the number of errors, objective errors, is quite high. ChatGPT and whatever comes next will almost certainly improve, and I do sincerely look forward to the later iterations. I hope you enjoyed this video and my interactions with ChatGPT. Please make a comment, leave a like, or subscribe to the channel. Take care.